Filmed from a distance, no hummingbirds were harmed during the making of these movies.
Have you ever seen a hummingbird nest? Hummingbird nests are very small and tend to be very well hidden. Few people have had the opportunity to actually see one of these tiny wonders. Since Anna's hummingbirds are seen all year in much of North Central Washington, it is only natural for people to suspect that they nest in the area, yet only a few empty nests have been documented. In 2021, the opportunity to safely film a female Anna's hummingbird as she built her nest, incubated the eggs, and cared for her young provided what may be the first documentation of active and successful nesting in the area. Breeding Anna's have been confirmed in the Seattle area, but the Cornell Lab of Ornithology considers nesting in the Wenatchee area to be only a possibility. Filming this nest from start to finish was not only a gift, but the videos provide strong evidence of nesting success as Anna's hummingbirds expand their range to the north and east. Female Anna's do all the work. The male abandons the area after mating to search for additional mates. The female finds a protected site, usually 6 to 20 feet off the ground, to build her nest. On average, it takes her about 7 days to construct the nest. Anna's generally nest between December and May, with the earlier nesting occurring in warmer geographic areas. Our first view of this nest occurred on March 3, 2021. The female adult had already built a nest about 3/4 of an inch tall as we began observing. The final nest was just over 1 inch high and about 1.5 inches in diameter. Typical nests are about 1/2 to 3/4 of an inch deep. A ping pong ball is bigger. Nest building is not a random act. The female attaches the first material to a branch with spider webs. She then makes 3 to 4 trips to bring plant material to the nest, followed by 2 trips to bring additional spider webs. Spider webs are extremely strong, and she uses them to bind the nest and keep it flexible for when the young grow and fill the nest. She adds new material to the nest in the morning hours and shapes and firms the nest during the afternoon. To help conceal her hemispherical nest, she ornaments the outside with lichen, mosses, dead leaves, and bark chips. There are several common nest-building motions. First, she brings the material to the nest and places it with her beak. She then stretches tall to use her long beak to place material along the sides or at the bottom of the nest. A loose feather may be grabbed from the top or outside of the nest and poked down into it. She will frequently make fine adjustments to the materials by moving small bits from one location to another or by poking materials into place with her beak. Occasionally, she will sweep her beak or a wing across the outside to add form and to consolidate the nest. Usually, after placing material, she will begin what looks like an energetic quivering. In actuality, she is stomping the material into place with her tiny feet. Sometimes she'll press her body into the side of the nest to form it. She repeats this sequence of bringing materials to the nest, followed by careful placement and vigorous compaction to build strength, form, and dimension until the nest is complete. Amazingly, she may lay her 2 eggs before she completes the nest. Once she begins incubation, she will be on the nest about 75% of the time. Her interludes away from the nest allow her to feed herself and gather the materials needed to complete the nest construction. The 2 tiny white eggs she lays are really small. Some say that the eggs are about the size of a Tic Tac mint. Others say a jelly bean is a good approximation. Researchers document that an egg weighs about 1/2 of a gram. Together, the 2 eggs weigh about as much as a single standard size paper clip. The female will incubate the eggs for 14 to 19 days, with the nestlings hatching at 16 to 19 days. The newly hatched birds are fingernail-sized downy miracles. They are born with their eyes closed and are totally dependent on their mother to care for them. We know that the babies have hatched on March 23rd when we see the mother perched on the side of the nest, probing her beak down into the nest's interior. Based on her beak movement to two different areas, we suspect that there are two young. The mother feeds the young by inserting her bill deep into the young's gaping mouth to regurgitate food while pumping her head up and down. She brings a variety of foods to her young. She delivers sucrose-rich nectar as well as protein-rich insects and spiders to support the young bird's energetic growth. She provides more protein than sugar in the afternoon and evening to give the young the most nourishment overnight. The young grow rapidly. Soon, their heads rise up to reach out as they feel air movement from the mother's wings as she approaches the nest. At 5 days, the young open their eyes to see the world for the first time. Their mother must look huge to them as she stands above them and pokes her beak into their gaping mouths with an up and down motion. The feeding motions of the mother may look forceful to us, but the species have been doing this successfully for eons. The mother continues to sit on the nest to provide the needed shelter and warmth to the babies. Until they begin to develop feathers, they are not able to thermoregulate, and the mother's heat keeps them alive. Within a week of hatching, the young begin to develop pin feathers. They look prickly and are beginning to fill the nest. The mother continues to bring food to their ever-hungry mouths. Within 2 weeks, the young are feathered and practice using their wings. Each of the young begins to vigorously flap their wings to develop the muscles and skills they will soon need. It's an exciting time. About 3 weeks after hatching, it is clear that the young are nearly ready to fledge. They continue to practice flying within the nest, but may climb up onto the nest's edge to flap some more. They are fully feathered, and their beaks, while still not fully grown, are beginning to look like real hummingbird beaks. The nest that the mother so carefully built is stretched by the two young birds. The kids occupy the nest totally, and the female adult finds that she can often not perch on the nest edge to feed the young. She resorts to perching on a nearby branch and stretching to probe their mouths to give them food. For 45 days, plus or minus a couple of days, the activity has been non-stop and thrilling to watch. We witness the careful and strategic building of the nest. During their time in the nest, these young experience 45 mile per hour winds and temperatures ranging from 27 to 67 degrees Fahrenheit. One night, 3 inches of snow bent the tree's boughs into nest-concealing arcs. Through all this, the mother and kids continued on with their biological schedule. The successful raising of two young Anna's hummingbirds is a biological miracle. There are so many risks and challenges that the birds need to overcome. And the challenges don't end when they fledge. After a short period in which they still rely on mom, the young fly off to begin their independent lives. And then they were gone. April 13, 2021 was the last time we saw the young. On April 14th, the nest was empty. When we last saw them, they were clearly ready to fledge, and we knew it was coming. Nonetheless, seeing the nest empty for the first time was a bit of a blow. We'd come to expect another day of watching the miracle of the young hummingbird's growth and the adult's steady care. In an age where we hear so frequently about habitat fragmentation and loss, bird population declines, and species at risk of extinction, it boosts our faith in a small bird's ability to find its way in a dangerous world, to expand its range to the north and east, as it continues to thrill us with its antics and energy in our gardens and at our feeders. It is truly time to celebrate the Annas.